white fat girl fights for integration. That was a good idea I had. First an independent film, then a Tony Award-winning Broadway musical, followed by a big Hollywood movie remake. Plus, I'd been paid to write a sequel to the musical that didn't happen, then a weekly Hairspray TV show based on my original movie that also didn't get made, and recently a special event TV movie sequel for cable that also went into turnaround. But you can't kill Hairspray. Now, NBC is doing the musical live on network TV this December. Hey, I used to want Hairspray on ice, but now, what the hell? I want them to do Hairspray in space. Today, we're taking Hairspray in a whole new direction, the symphony orchestra. If it works, maybe someday I can come out and hum Bolero while old people like me make out in the audience. A concert version, like what we're doing here, is basically the cast singing and dancing all the songs, dressed in full costume and doing most of the dialogue from the musical version. Here's where I come in. I'm the narrator. Use your imagination. I'm here to speed things up when we can't use celluloid dissolves or fade outs or change the scenery like they do in Broadway. Think of me as your friendly editor. Next number, please. Let's move it along. We only get 2 hours here tonight. Okay, Baltimore, 1962. Right after Elvis and right before the Beatles. In other words, the real 60s hasn't happened yet. No hippies. Kids got high on cough medicine, not pot. Hair was high, not long. Very, very high. Matter of fact, there's a secret Baltimore word to describe the citizens who went overboard on teased, ratted, bouffant hairdos. Hair hoppers. And that's us tonight. We're hardcore hair hoppers and proud of it. Baltimore's Highland Town. Eastern Avenue row houses made of formstone, a polyester of brick. White marble steps so clean you could eat dinner off of them, mothers used to brag. A bar and beauty parlor on every corner. Working class, blue collar, and bursting with teenage style. Home of the Turnblad family. Meet Tracy. An amber white girl who can't get enough of rhythm and blues music. Her best friend, Penny Pingleton, not as brave as Tracy in the hairdo department, but yearning to rise to the same height of social rebellion. Tracy's mother, Edna, turned around. Always played by a man so the audience, never the other characters, is in on the secret. Edna's on doctor-prescribed diet pills, but she's still hungry, taking in the neighbor's ironing to make ends meet. Her husband, Wilbur. Proud owner of the Hearty Heart Joke Shop, our good-hearted laugh riot if there ever was one. Never tires of the sound of a whoopee cushion, no matter how many he sells. And yes, sadly, Penny Pingleton's mother, Prudy, so uptight racially that the mere sight of a black person sends her into spasms of paranoia. The Buddy Dean Show, my local inspiration for Hairspray. If you were on the committee, the regular teenage dancers on the show, you were practically as famous as the Mouseketeers. In Baltimore, at least. The only city that broadcast the show. In 1962, the world was a mess. Segregation, excuse me, separate but equal, was still quite evident. No, life was not fair then, and Hairspray is the story of how I wish things had turned out. But we're talking musicals here, not documentaries. So imagine the best. Sit back and get ready for the nicest kids in town as they were built without irony. Ladies and gentlemen, the host of my dream dance party in the sky, Mr. Corny Collins.
Squares behind, shaking, shaking, shaking like the news. some of your personal stains required pounding on a rock.
Wait, hurry, hurry! The show's already started. We're gonna miss Mom. Mama, I'm home.
Tracy Turnblad, mind your manners. Say hello to our guests.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton.
And you, Penny.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton. I mean, Mother.
Teenagers, they just won't watch in that corny Collins.
Don't play noise. It ain't right, Dan, for that color music.
Oh, don't be silly. It ain't colored. The TV's black and white.
Kids, you'd like to lead the way. And once a month we have our
meet the
day. And I'm a man to spend an hour on Mr. Corny Cars with the latest, greatest, Baltimore sound. So every afternoon I drop everything. No needs to even ride when you can dance and sing.
Tell
your mother she wants you.
Oh,
hurry
to Tracy!
Rush hour traffic.
How is my foxy wife and my pretty little princess, huh? My two funny honeys?
Oh, Wilbur, you're the funny one.
You are.
No, you are.
You. Don't be silly.
Daddy!
You.
Daddy! Tomorrow, I'm auditioning to dance on a TV show!
No one's auditioning for anything. And what did I tell you about that hair? All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel. No wonder you're always getting put in detention.
Detention!
Well, talk to her.
Grace, this TV thing, do you really want it?
It's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it, babe. This is America. Why, when I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus. And I said, no, I've got dreams of my own. You follow your dreams. You, oh, ooh, we will see you later, alligator.
Wilbur, you're not helping.
Thanks, Daddy.
Tracy Turnblad,
you get back here.
Police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good! Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. Now I am willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown, but you have got to work with me! Now, let me at that zit. Don't contradict me! Don't disobey me!
Don't even think about going to that audition!
Please! No!
Can't win his love, well, just wait and see. But I can do that.
Let me tell you about Velma von Tussle. She doesn't give anybody a chance to show anything that's new. She put the fright in white, the itch in rich. She's mean, she's angry, and she doesn't have talent. But that doesn't stop her. Velma's more than Corny's hands-on producer. She's manipulative, unfair, vindictive. Plus, she likes the music of Shelley Fabre more than Ike and Tina Turner. She's the opposite of soul, and boy, oh boy, does Velma von Tussle think she's something. The top of the heap, the lady with more home improvements than any other gal in East Baltimore. She'll never forget one big local moment in the sun either. Velma von Tussle, it's 1962. But your time has passed.
Oh my God, how times have changed. That girl's like a blind or completely deranged. The time seemed to halt when I was Miss Baltimore. Crass. Childhood dreams for me were cracked when that damn Shirley Temple saw my friggin' act. But the crowds in the vault from an eye won Miss Baltimore. If a playmaker spin in their dance, ha, I'm not a tan, cause I hit the stage, batons ablaze, while belting Aida and preparing Jesus' plays. But that triple somersault was how I clinched his Baltimore crash. Fire away, girls.
Are you scared we're online? Oh, I'm sure I can cope.
Well, this show isn't broadcasting. Cinemascope, I never drank one chocolate ball. Not in Baltimore,
really. Where's Corny? I'd love to dance for him.
Well, I'm the producer, and may I be frank, first impressions can be tough. And when I saw you, I knew it. If your size was enough, that left answer just blew it. And oh, my ears were short, and Stubbs, you'll never be in, so we're kicking you out. With your fall and your face, but it isn't your fault. They're just caught with a case of Miss Baltimore. Your freedom.
Thank you. Excuse me, ma'am. May I please audition?
Of course not.
Real-life inspirations from which to draw this character. Like Ruby Bridges, the brave little black girl painted so miraculously by Norman Rockwell for Look magazine. There she is in 1960, hair in braids, party dress freshly pressed, holding her head high, ignoring the taunts of racist parents as she is escorted by federal marshals to an all-white school in New Orleans on the first day of integration. Or the much less well-known Gloria Lockerman, the 12-year-old black girl from Baltimore who shot to national fame by spelling correctly the word anti-disestablishmentarianism on the highest-rated TV show, The $64,000 Question. I love Gloria even more when she sensibly quit the show in later weeks and took home the $16,000 prize to use towards her education rather than risk losing it by going to the $64,000 level. Gloria Lockerman, you made the right decision. Young, gifted, and black. We didn't have that expression in 1962. But because of examples like these two, we soon would. Ruby Bridges, Gloria Lockerman, Little Inez is for you.
Get out! Megan, please just audition? Absolutely not! Now get out! I know every step. I know every song. I know there's a place where I belong. Why do they have to be so mean? You're short, you're stout, you're not council material. I wear all the latest fashions. I keep up with all the styles. I'm teasing my hair as high as I can. Will they give me a chance? Encouragement? Appreciation?
Hairdo has once again prevented your fellow classmates' clearer view of the blackboard. As principal of Patterson Park High School, I hereby condemn you to 3 more days of detention. I always liked detention. In real life, a great way to meet all sorts of the so-called bad kids from other classes you haven't even met yet. For me, detention was my own personal Cannes Film Festival of juvenile delinquency.
I see you in detention just about every single day, and it never seems to bother you.
Oh, but it does, baby. Ah, now that is my way of complaining. Hey, it's how I use my blues.
You use your blues, brother. You gotta use them.
Here's a little song signified to say to you, hello, my name is Seaweed, Chase Nervin. What's your, go ahead, Seaweed.
Hello, my name is Tracy, Turnblad.
Not bad for a white girl. Hey, I'm white, black up in here. Detention is a rainbow experience. Come on.
Your mom is Motormouth Maybelle, the detail Negro Day. That makes you like royalty. Negro Day is the best. I wish every day was Negro Day.
Baby, well, at our house it is.
Tracy Turnblad, smiling, laughing, dancing in detention. I'm putting you in special ed with the rest of these.
Well, special ed? Where do you go after special ed?
Congress!
Of our council, causing a double warning and death. tell us about yourself, Trace.
Well, I go to Patterson Park High, I watch your show, and I do absolutely nothing else.
Oh, so, Tracy, tell us, Drew, how would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No!
Will now sing to the equally blooming Tracy Turnblad his version of this week's top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
Must be expelled. There's a stamina beauty that must be upheld. You can say I'm a bigot, but it just isn't true. Look, I have
everything changes when you're famous. On the street, in school, on the bus, in the joke shop, and especially at home. Edna is suddenly the mother of a star, a big one in real life, and you know how the camera can add 10 pounds, and he's a bigger one on TV.
Why, thank you. Tracy is a lovely girl.
Then finally the call of all calls comes through. The one, the mighty, the all-powerful, iconic leader of fat girl fashion.
Mama, I'm home!
Oh. Turn back, residents. It's for you, Tracy.
Triple A.
Oh, Mama! I've hit the Mama load! Step inside,
Wigglies.
Three packs a day.
Oh, that chewing must make the muscles in your mouth mighty strong.
Well, I am pretty popular.
All right, team, listen up. That was one nut busting game of scavenger hunt ball. And I know, because I got a sack of balls. Class dismissed.
Girl,
Miss Motormouth?
I'm a petty little Pingleton, and I'm very pleased and scared to be here.
You're welcome, kid, to come and sit in. And you're dressing. I see you all aglow on Corny's show.
Well, gee, thanks. But the only reason I'm on the show is because of your son. Why can't we all dance together like this on TV?
Well, we do. What?
I saw! Wilbur! It was the kids I saw!
Mom, what are you doing here?
My funny honey had a sudden craving for some chicken and waffles. Yeah. Hi, everyone, we're Tracy's folks. Wow, this looks like a blast. Hi, I wish you kids could dance together like this on TV.
Thousand. She said you gotta love yourself from inside out, and just as soon
I'm beautiful.
You're beautiful.
And yes, I'm beautiful.
Get on TV? You wanna bet?